Hey guys, good morning. Mr. Willow's back. We're going to do a little bit of math again. Today we're going to be talking about using a sample to create predictions. Okay, so during election times, elections are usually in the fall, October, November, and people want to know, like, oh, I wonder who's going to win. We'll see. What they do is newspapers or media will do samples. They'll ask, 1,000 people who you're going to vote for, maybe rank your top one, two, or three, just to kind of get a feeling. I mean, they're not going to ask every Canadian out there in the population, right? They're not going to take a census poll where you ask everyone. That would just take way too long. So what they do is they create a sample. And with that sample, they're able to break it down and make predictions for the whole population of Canada, all those adults who want to vote. So today we're talking about using a sample or a part of the total population of people to make predictions. Okay, so we're going to do one. We're going to make a couple examples here. This is our first example, a little close to home. So, should New West get a new ice rink? New West has, I just googled it, approximately 80,000 people living here. It would take way too long to ask everyone, so let's take a sample of 400 people. So we're just going to make this up. I'm pretending that I asked 400 people total, 180 said yes, 160 said no, and 60 said maybe. Okay, so I want to use this data to make predictions for 80,000 people. And I'm going to show you how we're going to do that. So I'm going to erase this side of my notes. Again, just rewind. If you need to see this again. Okay, so this is where I'm going to do my work, over here. Okay, so, we have 180 people that said yes. What I need to do is I need to turn that into a percent. I need to find the percent of people that said yes. So you do that, this is a refresher. You take your 180 people that said yes, and then you divide it by your total, 400, okay? That's going to give us a percent. So, my calculator, I am going to go 180 divided by 400. That's going to give me 45%, 0.45. I'm going to keep that as a decimal. So 45% of people said yes, okay? The no's was 160 divided by 400. Okay, so we're going to go 160 divided by 400 equals 0.4, 4 tenths, 40%. Okay, so 40% said no, and maybe 60 divided by 400, divided by 400, 15%. Okay, so what do you do now? We have our percentages of our sample. That's good. Let's use these percentages of our sample to find out how many people we can predict for 80,000, right, in U.S. Winston. So, this is what you do. You take your 45% that said yes in your sample. And you got 45% of, in math, multiplication is of. So 0.45 of 80,000. Okay, same thing here. You take your 40% that said no. Of 80,000. And then your 15% of 80,000. Okay? So here we go. With our calculators. 45% of people in our survey said, yes, we want a new pool, new us. So let's find out how many we can predict would say that. So 0.45 of 80,000 equals. So we would predict 36,000 people in New Westminster would say yes. 36,000. We could predict 40% of 80,000. We could predict 32,000 people would say no, and we would predict 15% of 80,000. We would predict 12,000 would say maybe. So, why is this information important? Well, let's say you're the mayor of New Westminster. Okay? And you're like, I don't know. I mean, do majority of the people want a pool? Because I'm not going to go and spend all this money on something people don't even want. And that could get me, as a politician, maybe voted out of office. Because people were like, hey, you spent all, you wasted all that money on that swimming pool. Okay? So, let's think here. If I'm the mayor of New Westminster, I say, okay, well, I'll predict that 36,000 people want this pool. Well, 36,000 is not even half of New Westminster's population. So right there, it's kind of a red flag saying, you know what, most people don't really want a pool. But you can look at the maybes, the 12,000 maybes, and say, well, hold on. What if I can get, I don't know, 10,000 of those maybes to be a yes? Well, if I could change the mind of these maybes and add them to the yes, that means, you know what, maybe a pool is something for the city. Now, in elections, you know, Justin Trudeau, if he had a lot of yeses, and then maybe he could swing some of the maybes in his favor, he would know that, you know what, this is a good time to call an election, or I have a good shot of winning this election. So this is why we do samples, because it takes way too long to ask everybody in New Westminster about a pool. So you might just do a sample of, 400 people. You might take a day, you might put a survey online, you might even go, you and 10 friends go knock on people's doors, in Queensboro, Queens Park, Uptown, Sapperton. You might just go knock on doors and say, hi, what do you think about a pool? Yes, no, maybe, So you can easily do a sample of 400 people in a day. If you're going to ask every person in the U.S., 80,000 people, it could take a week, 2 weeks, and you might not have that much time, okay? So that's how you use samples to make predictions for a bigger population, okay? So thanks for watching. Okay, it's a couple steps. You're going to want to have a calculator for this lesson, okay? Please rewind, go over it again. These videos are your notes, right? So think of this as your notes, and if you have any questions, ask me in the chats that we're going to be having this week, or send me an email. All right, guys? Miss you guys. Take care.